Hey, what's up? What's up? What's up, guys? What's going on, man? You already know me. I'm going to the barbershop. Taking me a little walk to the barbershop, man. Gotta keep my eyes on the door. Yeah, that's what I thought. I gotta keep my eyes on the thugs. What's going on, man? Yeah, because it's the wrong street to be walking with your phone out like this. So, you know, I might get some hard stabs and stuff like. So, hola, buen dia. Look at that over there with them blue shorts on. Oh. Yeah, we live right now, baby. Yeah, man, what's going on with you guys, man? What's happening? What's up, man? Nah. Hey, Fred, Fez, I appreciate it, man. You say put the phone down, but I'm at the top of my best now, you know? So I got my head on the swivel, you know what I'm talking about? I think Puerto Plata is the move, or Santiago. I'm packing up and moving. I'm packing up and moving in 4 to 5 months. That's a good thing, man. That's a good thing. We out here in the local community in Santo Domingo. As soon as this white car leaves, you can see a little more action. We got more action over there, people sitting down, you know. We got my guys over here. So we all just chilling, man. This my guy right here. You know, so right now I'm in my comfort zone, so you know. I'm right here on the block, right here in Maria Asadolia. You know, in case anybody wanna pull up, you know, this is where I'm at, you know what I'm saying? Down here in this area, Santo Domingo, not far from Zona Colonia. We live right now for the world to see. You know what I'm talking about? Look at this beautiful thing. Y'all say y'all want to see some thick Dominicans. Well, there you go. She's chubby. You know? She's chubby. We chilling out this thing, man. What's up? What's going on with y'all guys, man? See, I got the shade right now. I'm at the barbershop, so you know. Gotta get this thing cut. Say, man, you got anything coming in as far as finances versus going out? What budget looking like? What made you comfortable to move out there? Well, you always gotta have something coming in versus going out. It just, you got to have more, even in America. You got to have more going in, coming into your accounts, than going out of your accounts. So living out here with businesses in America would definitely keep you afloat forever, really. You know, so even if you have like a your own barbershop in America, you own it, but you have barbers, you don't have to physically be there to put your manual labor into it. If you're one of them people who like working for yourself, and you got to be the main source of the benefits of your company, then you're gonna have a slight problem, because if you remove yourself from your business, then your business gonna crash. But if you're one of them people who can create a system and have that system moving, no matter what that system is, as long as it's bringing something in more than what's going out, then you'll begin to see a budget and how to relocate. Like I said, man, I haven't even made up my mind whether I'm staying here permanently or not. Right now I'm still building here. Once I get built enough here and I feel like, okay, now I'm comfortable, I can leave and come back and leave and go somewhere else. You know what I'm saying? I may pick another country and go to and start doing the same thing. You understand what I'm saying? So that's what made me comfortable. When I got here and realized, okay, first of all, it ain't as cheap as I thought it would be unless you're outside of the tourist area. Once you're outside of the tourist traps, then everything becomes more reasonable and all that right there. So once I realized that and figured that out, I was a little more comfortable and said, okay, yeah, let me continue to grow from where I'm at now. Let me dumb it down a little bit. Let me stop buying all my different shoes and all of this, and let me stop spending money in unnecessary places. And here you don't have to worry about spending money on so much of your fashion like in America. Here, you can dumb it all the way down and then handle your business. So this is my guy right here, you know. He started his own little local business, training guys how to fight and boxing, and then also he got his own little car wash thing going on. This is whole little water pressure thing that him, his sister, and I, and a couple more people got together, got him his own little car wash, his little sprayer, his so yeah, that's something good. My brother out here, man, he able to make his money and help his family. So that's pretty much good, man. So that's what we try to do, man. Help folks, man, you know, do what they do. Let me see what these comments hitting on right quick, like. Philadome, I see you, champ, doing your thing. Keep the videos coming. Hey, I appreciate it, big bro. You know, I definitely got to keep the videos coming and keep the most beautiful women around me, you know. Hold on, let me check this out. I might got to do a cold approach, depending on... Cold approach. Thought I was going to have to do a cold approach. Y'all going to see a cold approach out here. They keep playing, but you know, yeah, Philly Dome, a nice-looking, handsome brother like myself, man. You know, have my way with the women. Ain't got to worry about paying for nothing and none of that. Ain't got to go through all the bullshit, man. You know I got to keep dropping that content. You know I got to keep putting it in these niggas' faces, man. I got to keep rubbing it in their mouth and sticking it, force-feeding it down their throat, man. You know I got to keep doing that, man, you know. Yeah, you know what's going on. What's up, bro? Is it safe to smoke a J out there? Yeah, that's all they doing over here, man. That's all my guys doing over here. They sitting back smoking, doing their thing, man, you know. That's all I'm going to say about that. A budget 25 bands. And I'm day trade. I budgeted 25 bands, and I'm day trade. You good, bro? Just come out here without the expectations or without the mentality of an American man. Come down here, get you a nice ass, most beautiful, gorgeous, drop dead woman. That's gonna help you build. You know what I'm saying? That's gonna help you save money. Gonna teach you the ropes. Put you in places where you need to be at. And then just fall back, chill, and start slowly building and investing in entities out here that can bring you back money also. Even if you gotta open up a little commodore, just put some people in the commodore, in the community, to work, let them handle that shit. You just cut your little overhead off and then make sure they paid well. You know what I'm talking about? Even if you gotta open up something like, something that's not out here that you think of, like a fucking barbecue shack that's just really just focused on American style food, you know, and chaining out to different places, you know. As long as you can create something here that keeps you from using up what you already trying to save and all that, you're good. Fred Fells. All right, Extreme Pits, say King Lockett, yeah. CC got little on you. Man, nobody worry about that dude. Matter of fact, don't even talk about that guy over here, man. That guy is a... We don't even know who that woman is, man. I don't even know who that woman is. I don't watch nothing. I don't do nothing. So I don't want that energy brought over here. If you want to tell it to somebody, go over there on his side and talk about that shit. Don't bring that shit over here, man. You my partner now. I fuck with you, but... God, now I don't want to hear nothing about what a bitch nigga talking about me about. You know what I mean? Got my dick all in his mouth, man. I ain't worried about that, man. You know what I mean? I'm out here doing my thing with the baddest of women, man. And I'm displaying it. See, motherfuckers wish they can do that. The baddest of women doing and I'm putting it on display. See, a lot of motherfuckers can't put on display because they too beta. They too bitch made. And then they got the goddamn hype because they got a female running their life. They might got a girlfriend. They be like, I don't wanna do this. I might hurt her feeling, man. Fuck her. You let her run your shit. You know what I'm saying? I'm a god, man. You understand what I'm saying? I'm doing motherfuckers wish they could do, man. You know what I'm saying? Coming from scratch, ground zero and up, man. You know what I mean? I'm doing what motherfuckers wish they could, man. And I praise the Most High and my ancestors. So, anytime a motherfucker talking about me, man, I look at that as free publicity. I feel like I'm Kevin Samuels right now. Shout out to Kevin Samuels. I feel like I'm O'Shea Duke Jackson right now. I feel like I'm Taylor Made right now. I feel like I'm one of the big pioneers right now when motherfuckers worried about what the fuck I got going on, you know what I mean? Especially motherfuckers with more subscribers than me. If you got way more subscribers than me, then why the fuck am I on your damn checklist? Shit. Nah, you know what I mean? So I ain't worried about that, man. You know, jealousy is a crazy disease, man. You know, if a motherfucker gotta let a bitch influence him to do some dumb shit, that's stupid as fuck. That's stupid as fuck, man. I'm not worried about none of that, man. You know what I'm saying? I contacted the embassy, man. I contacted the FBI to lock that shit on down, man, and go find that shit, man. So the more he posting, the more he got to worry about shit. I can't beat him at game. I got to beat him at their own game. That's getting the law involved, because that's what they like to do. All right? So, man, I'm done with that shit, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm doing my thing out here, man, with the baddest of women around me. Doing my thing, man, out here in these streets. I'm in the hoods. I'm in the barrios. I'm in the suburbs. I'm in the business areas. I'm with the politicians. I'm doing everything I'm supposed to be doing as a young black man out here abroad instead of talking about another man, especially another black man. That's what's wrong with the black community, man. That's why we'll never prosper. Cause we can't keep each other, we can't uplift each other. We gotta keep talking shit to each other and bringing each other down, you know what I'm talking about? So that's what that's all about, man. So don't come over here telling me about what no goddamn bitch talking about on another channel, man. Let that shit stay over there and you let that shit entertain you. You go over there and look at that shit, man. Don't bring that shit over here, man. We don't do that shit over here. Where we at now? Cloven Spark. Okay. Minecraft Netzeal. That's it, man. That's right. We're gonna keep this thing thugging, man. I'm gonna keep showing y'all these streets. I'm gonna keep getting y'all this good content, man. And I'm gonna keep opposing. See, this is what I do. I don't do no fucking, I told y'all this one time before, man. Extreme Pit, you should know this shit. Cause you on this damn channel, man. I don't do no beef shit with no fucking bitch ass niggas. I don't do no beef shit. I don't do no back and forth arguing. I don't do none of that shit, man. I'm too God for that, man. I'm too player, I'm too pimp. I'm too fucking, man, I'm too up there. You see what I'm saying? To be playing any type of game, so you should know this shit. The way I fight and the way I respond is, you say the Haitians want to kill me, I go to the Haitians. I go to Haiti. You say you looking for, I pull up. You say somebody looking for me, I'll go live with my location. You know what I mean? So that's the way I do. I don't have to talk. I do my shit with actions. You know what I'm saying? I do my shit with actions. You see what I'm saying? Whatever you say, I oppose that shit and walk up on it and look it in his face. That's how I do it. I ain't got time to be on the internet trying to goddamn impress motherfuckers who don't give a fuck about me at the end of the day. You know what I mean? And speaking of that, I'm going to do a goddamn a video. We're going to have the birthday dinner at restaurant number 66 in Sosua. Restaurant number 66 in Sosua. You know what I'm saying? On the beach. That's where we're gonna be at, man. That's where we're gonna be at for my birthday. So anybody that wanna see me, wanna get at me, wanna speak to me, say somebody looking for me, tell them to come to restaurant 66 on the beach. I keep telling y'all, man, stop listening to this troll shit, man, cause this shit ain't true. Come to restaurant 66, that's where I'll be at. I'll be there with Sester, tourist police, with National, local police. The mayor of Sosua will be there eating with me. Come on, man. Come down there and chill with me, man. That's what's going on, man. So anybody looking for me, that's where we're going to be at. We already done set it up, man. I already done reached out to everybody. Told everybody I'll be there, man. The embassy know where I'm at. You know what I'm saying? The police know where I'm at. You know what I'm talking about? What the fuck? What the fuck y'all niggas be talking about, man? Leave that troll shit over there, man. Come to me with some facts. When you come to me with some motherfucking facts, then I'll say, okay, let's face these facts. Goddamn, ain't nobody goddamn worried about no bitch-ass goddamn trolls and shit, man. Ain't got nothing else better to do but to suck on the tip of my dick until I bust in their mouth, man. That's all they doing. You see what I'm saying? They let them keep doing that shit, man. I'm that fucking beautiful. I look that fucking good with all these beautiful women. I'm that sexy. I speak all this good game. I'm doing shit that they ain't never seen before, so they ain't got no trouble but to talk. They ain't got no trouble but to throw darts. They ain't got no trouble but to goddamn try to bring down a motherfucking goddamn pill. put stains on this bleach character, you know what I mean? They can't do nothing but try to upset the pimping and the macking, man, but that ain't gonna happen, man. You know what I'm saying? So again, don't bring none of that fuck shit back on here, man. If you do, whether you my partner or not, man, I'm gonna have to get rid of you, man. That's facts. Don't come to me with that shit, man, about what a fucking bitch talking about. You know what I'm saying? Cause a hoe gonna do exactly what a hoe's supposed to do. You see what I'm saying? That's what a hoe gonna do. A hoe's gonna do what hoes do. That's gossip, that's talk, and all that shit. I don't do that shit, man. My shit is pure action. My shit is catered around all the women and catered around you men who like women. That's what my shit is about, man. We don't talk about men like that unless we uplifting another man. When we uplifting a brother, that's when I bring a brother up, man. I don't talk about none of this shit, man. I feel like I'm the great Taylor-made dreams. I feel like I'm the great Bo Rates, goddamn. I feel like I'm the great goddamn flip-flop Greg from flip-flop. That's my guy. I feel like I'm one of the greats, man. The way y'all got now shooting at me, man. I feel like I'm O'Shea Duke Jackson. Shout out to all these guys, man. I feel like I'm Kevin Samuels. I feel like I'm goddamn Malcolm X. Goddamn, I feel like I'm Big Meech, Larry Hoover. You know what I'm saying? I feel like I'm all that, man. God damn, what the fuck? You know, so what the fuck? I'm out here, a black man, just trying to get in my own lane, my own zone, and doing my own thing, man. We out here live right now in Santo Domingo, man. And these women are coming out. You know what I'm saying? We live right now, man. Doing our thing. I'm right here at the barbershop. About to get this haircut right now, man. Yes, I am a Black Panther brother, Fred Fells. Go on my Instagram, check it out. Oh, she beautiful. I might gotta go get her, hold on. Yes, I am a Black Panther, Fred Fells. Go on my Instagram, check it out. I am a stuntman. Let me look in your face when I say this. I am a standing active Black Panther member right now. You know what I'm saying? We rebranded ourselves to the new Black Panther Party. So I have nothing but all the intentions of bringing up my people all over the planet. You know what I'm saying? You'll never catch me doing anything foul to any one of my people if I can help it. You see what I'm saying? If I can't help it, goddamn, I'll try to die before it happens. You know what I'm saying? I am an active Panther member right now. You know what I'm saying? Right now. So yeah, I am a Black Panther. Yeah, man. So here we go right here. Like say right here, this person right here, Midnight Grow, before you get blocked right quick. Like, let me respond right quick. Midlife, you know. Why would I chase? Why would that go on when you got stuff like this going on? Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful women, man. You see what I'm saying? So look, the homie said, look what the troll said, y'all, before I get ready to block this troll. Let me just respond to it right quick. The troll, the Midnight Grove, and I'm gonna screenshot this too, man, so we can go on and turn this in to the authorities, but they told me to track all this little fuck shit down, y'all. Right? So listen, he said, not if we're out, you chasing little boys. Let me tell you something. It don't matter what word out saying from some bitch ass bitches, all right? The fact still stand that everybody know me. You understand what I'm saying? Everybody know me. So if it's that true, why the fuck I'm still standing here? The Dominican Republic don't play them type of games at all. They don't play that woman shit. Be no women. They don't play that goddamn pedophilia shit. That's one, them two things, and gay, homosexual pedophilia shit at that. Those are two things that the Dominican Republic will fucking kill, smash, concrete, stone your ass to death. They ain't gonna give a fuck about what country you from or none of that shit. You understand what I'm saying? Those are things that the embassy would be running their ass down here right now because they got my address, they got my passport information. As a matter of fact, if this so true, why don't you call the police right now? Why don't you get on the phone with the local authority and say, just like I told motherfuckers that tell me some shit about what a troll talking about. I said, why don't y'all go turn me in? Then I'm right here sitting right here. I don't run from no fucking body. Do that shit right now. Call him right now while we on the line. Tell him he on Santo Domingo right now. Sitting out here on the block of Maria Asadoria, right here at the barbershop, right up the street from the gym where he trained to work out at. The only thing you got to do is start asking people around here. I'm the only fucking foreigner, tattoos and shit. Dark shades, tattoos all over, muscular. They know exactly who I am and where I live at, brother. So go ahead and let them know I am here. And then I'll be in Sosua, like I said, for my birthday, eating dinner. Have them there also, all right? All right, thank you, brother. Until then, suck my dick, motherfucker. I'm gonna block this cat. All right, cool, here we go. Yeah, so that's all I'm saying. Whatever the fuck y'all talking about, or the troll talking about, that you know it's lies. And you're gonna know it's lies when I pull up at, when I pull up in Sosua, my ass gonna go straight to the people. The department, everything. I'm gonna let, and I'm gonna be videoing. So that's my little secret for y'all guys, man. Then after that, leave that shit alone. Look, bro, they coming after me because I'm on top. Fuckers wish they dick was the size of my dick. They wish they was fucking some of the women I was fucking for free. They wish they were doing a lot of things I was doing. Why do haters come at any goddamn body? When I'm on top of my shit, that's why the haters doing that. If the haters wasn't coming, then that would be a problem. You see what I'm saying? They tried the woman beating shit. That didn't work. So now they gonna try the pillowfill. So now they gonna try the pillowfill your shit. Why these goddamn women out here too bad? Then they gonna try to pedophilia and shit. When they see that ain't gonna work, and then they gonna try some more other shit, goddamn. But only thing I'm asking y'all to do is leave me alone with the shit. Y'all see the shit ain't working. You see that the shit with the female, it must not have been true, cause the motherfucker would have locked my ass up. The fuck? So then the bitch had to keep coming up with more shit. Now they trying, what they trying to do now is put it out in the streets. But the Dominicans, I got Dominicans calling me like, yo, man, we got people calling us talking about you this and that. I had to cuss their ass out. I said, appreciate it. I said, I'm glad you cussed their ass out, man. I appreciate it. So the Dominicans ain't going for that shit. Man, these people know me, man. You know what I'm saying? Look here, I'm going to tell you what the top is in a third world country. First of all, in a third world country, why are you looking at this channel? You understand what I'm saying? You watching me now. You see what I'm saying? The reason why you watching me is because you want to know what's going on with me. That's what I mean by top. You fucking idiot. That's what I mean by top. You ready? All right, let me get to this barbershop and this haircut. That's what I mean by being on top, meaning I'm doing my damn thing, the shit that they wish they could do. That's what I mean by top. And the third world country is 100 times better than America, I promise you that. Third world country ain't killing black men in the streets dead. You understand what I'm saying? Third world country ain't. Okay, you asked me a question like, what's the top of being out here? What you mean by that question then? If you make it make sense to me, then I'll say my fault, bro. Make it make sense to me. If it don't make sense to me, then you steal a cow, goddamn. Don't let them get, don't, oh, I ain't heated, bro. That's just how it is. I'm sitting in the barber chair, man, about to get a nice ass haircut, man. Let's step back out here in these streets. And trying to keep y'all on live at the same time, because I didn't know he was going to be ready for me this soon. But yeah, though, yeah, but that's what it is, man. So let's get off the troll shit. And let's pop this shit, man. So yeah, we're gonna have the birthday dinner down at the beach, and we're gonna do that thing like that. And that's where it's supposed, that's where I should be at anyway, cause that's the folks. You know, Flip Greg, that's my homie, you know what I'm saying? But I decided to do it on the beach cause I wanna be near some water. You know, it is Pisces season, I am a Pisces, so, and Pisces like to be around water, man, you know. So I decided to just have it down there instead of at the restaurant. Now I may stop by Flip Flop early that day, just for people who just to go down there and eat and support my good brother. Cause I love my good brother, you feel me? And then after that, I'm gonna shoot down to restaurant 66. And so y'all whipping the drum. Let's get these lights up, man. We got 8 people right here. We got 8 lights, 32 people. Let's put the lights up. Yeah, so what you guys got going on out there, man? Y'all ready to start traveling soon? So y'all see how the barbershop style go here, man. You know, this guy right here, he's one of the best. I've experienced maybe 3 guys who I consider were some very good barbers here in the Republic of Dominicana. And so he's one of the top ones. I have a guy in Sosua too who cut my hair, man, you know. But I think this one and him is pretty good. I got a guy in Portobello. What you say? I'm coming back there on Tuesday set for live production. What city you gonna be in? You gonna be up north or down south? Okay, we got Aquarius in the building. That's what's up. When you come back too, so you gonna be up top. You gonna be up top, or you? Where you going, Santo Domingo, Sosua, or what? Okay. Holler at me when you get here. Holler at me when you get here. See. Look here, man. I got an open door policy for everybody. Holler at me when you, I say that to all y'all. I think I am one of the only YouTubers or YouTube guys. I'm not even a YouTuber. I'm really a gangster. I'm just doing YouTube. You know what I'm saying? But I think I'm only one on YouTube, one of the fewest that actually like make every effort to meet you in person. You understand what I'm saying? I made every effort to try to meet you in person. Every effort. Yeah, I think I'm one of the ones that actually want to meet you. I tell everybody the same thing. Pull up. Holler at this cut right here is 200 pesos. Whoa. She ride harder than a lot of folks, ain't it? But guess what? That ain't even a mango right there. The one that pulled up in that white truck. I just got in the truck. Yeah, man, I don't do none of that online shit, man. You know, I did it live today to show y'all that I'm here, you know. And then I wanted to go live for anybody who think I'm running a hind or some shit to know, like I ain't. Because I ain't no reason to be doing it. And then even if it was a reason, I'm gonna go face the shit. You know, so I'm just putting it out here. So hopefully after this, after y'all see what the business really is, then you'll be like, okay, we ain't paying that guy no more attention, you know. You'll be like, man, you know, you ain't paying them hoes no more attention. So I tell you guys, don't come over here with that shit. I don't know, you gotta ask them, brother. go ask whoever you you want to talk to about that. I don't talk about other people, and I don't even want to know about other people, brother. And you about to get blocked too for asking all these bitch ass questions like a female, man. You got one more sis ass question to ask me, and I'm gonna block your ass. Crazy ass questions and shit. Say, what part of Santo Domingo is this? This is Maria Asadoria. Correcto, mi amigo. Maria Asadoria. You get that fresh haircut, you feel fresh. Thank you. Yeah. No, this area ain't really tourist friendly. So you gotta be real careful over here. Do you think it's possible to level up in the Dominican Republic and get better at gaming chicks when you get back to the States? For me, it don't really get no better. You know, I'm just at the top of my game and just living that way since high school. But I think it's based on the individual, whether or not they're able to level up or not, anywhere they're at on the planet Earth. I think that a man that's in tune with his God-like qualities, you know, and have enough experience in life, can level up anywhere, under any circumstances, you know. It took game when I was in prison to pull the correction officers. When I would get the correction officer females and have them calling, texting, and coming to see me and stuff, that takes game to do that. I think that was the toughest, because you got to avoid other inmates, you got to avoid eyes, you got to avoid cameras, and you got to convince her. So that's where the game was really at. So I feel like I'm on a level that's just way on another level. Does the DR have extraditions? Absolutely, with the United States of America. Donald Trump made that a law. Even if you're on child support here, and you try to run and go to America, they coming to get you from America. Even if you on the run or in trouble in America, they gonna send your ass back to America. Or America gonna come over here and get you. There are extradition laws here that supports America now. I don't know how long it's been in place, but I do know now it is, and I do know because of Donald Trump. Since Donald Trump been in office, him and his president that's in office now are really, really close, you know. They really close, and they got a good deal going on. So yes, the extradition laws is definitely intact. Ain't no such thing as committing a crime and hiding in the Dominican Republic. You cannot do that shit. You probably can hide in Cuba, but you ain't gonna hide right here. Not in the Dominican Republic, baby. So now that's a good question you asked. So I get time out, did you look good? You had time to think about what you wanted to ask me? And that's real good. You know, but yeah, I understand that. That's why I'm trying to connect with you. I'm trying to give you a chance, brother. But every time you ask a bitch ass question, I'm gonna put your ass in timeout till you tough up a little bit and have some alpha shit in you, and you come on out of timeout and you can come on and ask some real questions. You start asking some bitch made ass questions, I'm gonna put your ass back in timeout. You understand? You know what it is. If you got game, you got game, but just be yourself and respect people to women, and you should be fine, absolutely. Especially here. You know, these women out here are very, very, very feminine and very, very respectful. You have no choice but to be respectful to these women, you know. They just what it is. Ain't like you're dealing with the Snapdragon mouth. Shout out to Minister Jep. Ain't like you're dealing with the Snapdragon mouth nagging ass, angry woman that want to just bring a black man down every time she can't have her way. So you dealing with one of them motherfuckers, you'll be a fool to respect anything of that. Peace, King Lockett House, the beautiful DR. Man, it's beautiful, man. These girls out here sitting down having a good time. I'm getting a haircut because this is the weekend. And I want to go ahead and jump fresh. Yeah, the women in the States do like to choose. You know, in the States, you let the women choose. That's what it is, you know. That's the name of the game, you know. Let the woman choose. Here, the man choose, but at the same time, when it comes to unicorns, they choose. Yeah, Ali, I'm chilling. It's like $400 from New York to Puerto Plata, $200 from New York to Santo Domingo. Yeah, so if you're traveling to Santo Domingo, drive up to Puerto Plata. Just get on the bus if you want to. The bus ain't nothing but like $4. Look how much money you done save. And you looking at the scenery, and you looking at the beautiful people that's on the bus, and you kick back in a real comfortable-ass bus, it's Caribbean tours. And, you definitely enjoy that. Definitely something to enjoy. Punta Cana from Santo Domingo is probably like 5 hours. Probably, maybe 4. Oh yeah, you can. You can ask me to put it in Spanish. I got another gentleman right here. Just put the question in Spanish so he'll understand it and I'll let him see it. I got you there, brother. Yeah, no problem. I'm gonna let him see it, or I'm gonna hand the phone to this other guy. Hopefully, he'll run out of here with it. All women choose. You think you choose women? You might think you do, but they don't. But you don't. You're chosen before you know you are. You can't make a woman like you. She likes you from the first 5 seconds. You're absolutely right, set for life production. 1,000 with that coming. Okay, just write the question down. I give it to the barber. Clover Square, I don't know if you partake in smoke weed, but I heard rumors of Dominicans pet being bad. Is that true? Yeah, I don't smoke weed, but I heard that it's terrible as well. So, mi amigo, somebody wanna know?
Perfume.
The best. Tu no? Tu sabe? Okay. He said, give him a second to think about it.
Hombre.
If you are tricking, you are choosing. If you are looking for a girlfriend or a wife, the women choose you. I'm used to being chosen by beautiful women all of my life, so Latin America isn't abnormal for me. That's right. That's right. A lot of people don't have that quality that you have to be chose like that by the top-notch best women, you know, so. A lot of these men ain't got nothing but, they can't do nothing but throw money because it ain't nothing else about them that the woman would actually like. You know what I'm saying? They ain't in shape. They ain't fat. They ugly. Breath stink. Ain't got no game, no finesse, no romance, no creative, no creative nature. No way to impress a woman other than throwing a dollar out there. You know what I'm saying? Don't even know how to deal with women. So a lot of men don't have the quality that you have, brother. That's good, man. You blessed. Yeah, I actually sent for my own T-liners because the ones here had broke. And it was so difficult for me to find some more. So I got the good brother Kevin Kelly that you see in the comments. He's bringing my T-trimmers. And it's a birthday gift from him, and I appreciate it, brother. So great minds think alike. Yeah, so he coming with them. And I have him when he arrives. Cause I don't even like people doing my lines or anything. I like to do all that myself. I appreciate it, man. It'll be March 2nd. But you know, I'm gonna do like 90 days of celebration, you know? I feel it, but I'm speaking from experience. I can get some women, but I can't get everyone I want. And I better look. The problem's more. Oh, I gotta look at the problems that come with it. Oh, your birthday March 2nd too? That's what's happening, bro. You need to come on down here and eat with me. Yeah, man, Kevin Kelly, man, that's a good brother, man. You know, that's a good brother, man. And you know, we Pisces, we got a certain type of heart, man. And a lot of times we get fucked over because of our heart trying to reach out and deal with people and accept people. That a lot of times we see the evidence and we see in our mind that other people saying, you know, that person ain't right. But then a Pisces is just so optimistic and, you know, so compassionate and feel for others to the point to where we end up getting bit in the damn process of trying to help some fucking body else. That is what it is. That's what it boils down to. Asking about the cologne now.
Hey.
Yeah, I appreciate it, bro. Take it easy. So I'm assuming he don't really know what the best cologne is. That's why I was trying to ask one of these little youngins out here that probably, you know, a little more finesse than he is. But they pretty much have the same cologne we have, though. They have the polos, the the brands that we have in America. And then they have their own Dominican brands.
Brother.
Oh, no.
So my friend wishes.
Yeah.
Speak English.
What's a good cologne here? Like, for men. Yeah.
All kinds.
Yeah, he said. Polo.
Get the Malabo, Rabanne,
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, he's saying the same thing we have, like polo, curve. He's saying the same thing we have out there. So I asked him, you know, he seemed like a pretty player type guy, man. He in here, you know, pretty fresh. So, you know. Yeah, so he got the same. I appreciate it, bro. Gracias. So you say every female you met like vertical? Okay, now we got to find something like vertical that's not vertical, that's similar, but different, so you'll stand out. So the girls will be like, they'll be attracted to the smell because they think it's vertical. But then they're gonna ask questions like, whoa, hold on, that's not vertical. You know, cause you know, you don't wanna smell like every other man. Yeah. Yeah. Right. Okay, he's still naming. He's bringing me back now. See, at first, y'all, I was acting like I was looking. I was looking ugly, so I was acting ugly. But now the haircut just changed my whole swag, you know what I'm saying? Say that's the best. That's the best in the DR. So it's basically the same thing we have. They got it all. All right, now I'm back in my player Mac mode. Now I'm starting to look like I need to be active, you know?
Okay.
So if I cussed you out earlier, I was looking ratchet. So I was feeling ratchet. But now I'm feeling immaculate. Because I'm looking immaculate. Oh yeah, by my cologne. My cologne is a special cologne made for me, and it's called Panties Dropper. If you follow my social media, you'll see my Panties Dropper collection. You can look it up, you ain't gonna find it. But it's called Panties Dropper. And they have that hormone in it. You know. Minecraft Net South. Hit me up on IG at number1KING_Lockett. number1KING_Lockett. And we can exchange numbers. Yeah, I got some. My cologne is called Panties Dropper. Yep. I stick to Panties Dropper. That's what I've been wearing since I've been home, man. It works for me, man. It works for me. And I be the only one smelling like I'm smelling. Like, the women be falling behind me and shit, like, yo, calling me back after I leave, like, that. You left your smell in here, man. Oh my God, it smells good. I'm like, yeah, I know. Women be stopping me at the store, like, yo. Oh, Creed, my bad. Yeah, he say Creed. Say Creed is good. Creed, very good. Yeah, Creed is good. Women be stopping me at the store like, what you wearing? I want to get my husband some. But nah, you get your husband out of this. Matter of fact, if you tell me how, How can I take a live off my Facebook and put it on YouTube? If you tell me how to do that, I got a live. Well, I'm walking in the store the day of my mama's wedding, and I'm trying to get a towel or something from out the store, and I'm walking through the store, and I got that panty dropper on, and I'm just walking. This thing I know, this man just come out of nowhere, all aggressive. What are you wearing? I said, hold on, bro, what are you wearing? So my brothers and stuff like, yo, bro, what the fuck? I said, it's called panty dropper, and he was just so desperately in need for it. He the only one I ever gave my secret to. I said, hey, man, listen, I'm gonna help you get some. And I gave my whole shipload. You know, so tell me how to do that. Take my live off Facebook and put that motherfucker on YouTube. And I'm gonna show you this shit. I mean, it's just the person who makes the cologne, they actually made it. And when they made it, they had me to try it. And when I just fell in love with it, and I just never ever gave up who the distributor is, you know. And that's just what it is. I tell you what, you tell me how to take my Facebook, my Facebook video and put that motherfucker on YouTube, you gonna get you some panty dropper. That's my word. But you gonna have to write a disclosure though, goddamn. You ain't gonna be able to tell nobody where that shit at. Confidentiality, people. So don't worry about that paperwork. Gonna make sure you don't tell nobody. I ain't worried about that. But yeah, that's what I wear. I don't give a fuck about creed. I don't give a fuck about goddamn savage, sauvage. I don't care about none of that. Polo, Ralph Lauren, none of that shit. I put that panty drop on. And there's also another one that my mama, I gave her some Black Woman. And I'm sure you know about Black Woman. And I have some Black Man, but I never really wear it, but it smells very good. And I'll tell you that, it's called Black Man. And my mom got a Black Woman. And I do have some, Bigelow. Now Bigelow isn't that expensive, but you can find Bigelow in Macy's somewhere. It's not expensive at all, maybe $30 maybe. But it has a certain hormone in it that drives motherfucking women crazy, especially if you like the older women, like the 28s, 38s, 48s. You definitely gonna get their attention. Bigelow and Macy's, or either JCPenney's, or either one of the stores in the mall like that. Bigelow been around for a little minute, but Bigelow definitely have the women like, yo, what the fuck, man? The point is, try to smell like the popular colognes, but not what everybody wearing. You don't want to smell like every fucking body, man. You know what I'm saying? How much is it on Amazon? I haven't purchased it in so long, but I'm very familiar with it. The blue bottle, yes. How much is it on Amazon, Bigelow? That shit $190? Damn. You mean $1.99? Damn, that shit went up. Bigelow ain't never been that fucking much. My bad, guys. Bigelow ain't never been that much, man. When I had Bigelow before I even got locked up. It's like 13, 14 years ago, goddamn. I was wearing Bigelow. You know what I'm saying? And that shit was like $30, man. Damn, okay. Bigelow. It went up.
Primero que tú.
Ah, bien. Tú vas a por Leo aquí detrás.
Claro. Thank you.
I told you about $30, man. Amazon really tripping. $20. I'm tripping like a motherfucker. I'm about to say, I used to faithfully buy them bottles of Bigelow. Some good deodorant. You got the deodorant that complement it, you know. So I'm not saying get a matching deodorant. Get the powdery speed stick. With the good scent to it, it usually offsets the Bigelow. And then you know, just make sure your skin shiny. Okay, Old Spice might do it. I never tried it with Old Spice. Old Spice might do it. Because Bigelow got that little clean, fresh, like, it's a certain type of smell that I like. And it's like the closest thing running the lines of panty dropper as well. Your coconut oil perfect. You want to, you're a black man or something, you want to make sure your skin is shiny at all times. I ain't talking about five heartbeats, Jerry Curl juice shining. I ain't talking about that. So you know, just got that little shine to it, you know. You want to make sure your line don't be fucked up like mine, you know. So you want to make sure you're good. Then you want to say hola. You want to say kill okay. They watching you. I want that girl up there, man. I'm gonna get her tonight. It's a beautiful woman up there, man. I'm gonna get her. I'm gonna get her. It may not be today. It may not be tomorrow. But I got to get them. Something about them curly heads, man. Big natural curls, honey. High class, lino, cielo, las colinas, exilium, Europa. But yeah, you want to make sure, black man want to make sure that skin shining, man, and everything on point. It's Barbara right here, man. Barbara, yeah. Look, you get all this done for 200 pesos. 200 pesos, man. Yes, 200. Let you see it if you don't believe back. Yeah, Yes, bro. Yes, yes. Yo. Right, I'm back, guys. Check me out. It's yours truly, man. The one they love to hate. Oh, shit. Uh-huh. I'm back. Oh, he done brought me back. Oh, yeah. Look at that. He done brought me back. Look at that. Uh-huh. See, uh-huh. Americano Dominicano. Ah. Look it out, see? Hit me with the hater powder. Hold this for me, hold this. Hold this right here for me. You brought me back, baby. Appreciate it. Good. Yeah, man, we out here in the streets. Oh, there she go right there. Let's go with them blue jeans on. That's what I want. I have to get her. With the blue jeans on right there, that's what I want. Bella. Bonita. Bonita. Bella Linda. Chica. I ain't gonna even do it. Can y'all hear me? Can y'all see me? Can you hear me? Can you see me? Well, I'm about to go get her. But, what's going on with you, Moreno? Moreno. You hear the little kids say, Moreno. I just had to look in the nail salon. There we go. Yeah, so we chilling. Yeah. Hola, hola, hola. Yeah, no problem. But yeah, man, you know, we out here chilling. What's up, man? Chico, Chico. Hola, que lo que? Que lo que? Yeah, man, so we out here in, hola, buen dia. We out here in Santo Domingo, man. We just hit the block. Let me go this way. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go this way. Yeah, let's go this way and see what's down here, guys. Hey, y'all still on? If you still on, man, give me a thumbs up or something, man, so I know you're here. So, you know, I won't think I'm talking to myself and be done hung this motherfucker up. All right, can y'all hear me? Can you see me? Thumbs up, put the number one. Can you hear me or can you see me? Can you hear me or can you see me? Good. Thank you. Appreciate it. We rolling. We in the streets. Santo Domingo. It's one of the toughest neighborhoods out here. This is called Maria Asadoria. If you don't believe me, Google it. If you don't believe me, ask somebody. This is where they tried to take my phone at that day. Same neighborhood, you know. So if you don't believe me, find out. We're in one of the toughest places in the Republic of Dominicana, Santo Domingo. What's the best area to stay in Santo Domingo? Zona Colonia is the best area. You know what I mean? Anywhere the tourists at. And see, that's why I'm by myself right now, because if I was with any type of Dominican, they would be scared as shit right now. Like, yo, man, why you got the phone out? Why you got the phone out? So I'm by myself so I can walk how I want to walk. Because ain't nobody finna take shit today. I see two girls over here. Let me see if they good enough to talk to. Nah, they look like two. No, but we chilling right now, man. That's what we're doing right now. We chilling. Damn, she pretty. I'm telling you, man. See, this is how you find your unicorn. See, I just passed. One unicorn sitting up there. She's sitting up there chilling. You know. See, and that's just how you get them. See, they don't come out the house. They ain't finna be walking out in the streets and shit. Not all the time like that. They're gonna be in the house chilling. Bonito. It's a beauty supply store. Hey, baby. Yeah, so now I'm in my player mode now, you see what I'm saying? I'm in my player mode. I can see you, can lock it, and I can hear you. Very good. Make sure y'all watching my back there. You see my back? Keep your eyes on my back. Yes, yes, man. It feels good to be me. Where my man's at? Oh, my God. Look at this. Oh, my God. Hold on. Now Nah, I don't know. Hola. How you doing? Y'all got me walking in the... Y'all got me walking in the wrong direction, goddamn. It was on one side of that, y'all didn't even catch that, did y'all, man? That's crazy. Y'all didn't even catch that, what I just saw. She made me walk a whole nother direction. Guys, are we still here? Now, she was beautiful, but I'm too close to where I lay my head at. So I ain't apply pressure because people can. Yeah, that's why you see me walking around here with my goddamn phone. Cause I'm like, you know, this is considered the toughest, but to me, it's like the suburbs of Atlanta. Like, it ain't nothing, you know? Oh, the old Atlanta. You know, this right here, like the new Atlanta, not the old Atlanta. The new Atlanta ain't hood, man. Oh, shit. Goddamn. See, that's why I didn't apply pressure. Now y'all see. I couldn't apply pressure. More stuff. You all right? Yeah. Okay, guys, we just spent like 86 minutes. So let me go ahead and freshen up, get in the shower. Still fuck my line up. Let me get in the shower and handle some business. And I'm gonna get back with you guys later. I'm gonna go live again later and we're gonna chop up smoke. Just remember, man, you know, I appreciate all of you guys' support. I appreciate all the love from all of you guys, man. Make sure you stay strong out there, man. And it's your boy, King Lockett. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe, man. You know, I'm finna turn it up a little bit, man. It's almost my birthday time, so you know we got to turn it on up. Baby, let's do it. All right? Let's get it. Peace.